Good morning, students. Last time you have learned the derivation of van der Waals equation. Let us revise once again the derivation of van der Waals equation. All of you know the van der Waals equation, it holds good to explain the behavior of real gases. And van der Waals made two assumptions in the derivation of the real gas equation or van der Waals equation, and that two assumptions are: first, it is the Fulham correction term and it is due to size of the gas molecules, and second correction term, that is the pressure correction term, and it is due to their H's intermolecular forces of attraction in between the real gases. Let us see the derivation of van der Waals equation. Here the real gas volume of gas molecules is negligible when compared to the total volume of the container. There are no forces of attraction or repulsion between the gas molecules under a low pressure and high temperature condition. Hence, the van der Waals suggested the following corrections. The gas molecules possesses finite volume and hence should not be neglected. It is especially true at high pressure and low temperature and should be counted. In case of real gases, both the force of attraction as well as repulsion operate between the gas molecules. And it should be noted here, if the gas obey the kinetic theory of gases, then they cannot be compressed since the attractions between the gas molecules is negligible. Hence, the first correction here, it is the Fulham correction. The Fulham available for the gas molecules is less than the volume of the container, that is free volume. The available volume is obtained by subtracting excluded volume of n moles of gas, that means nb, from the volume of the container. Suppose phi is the volume available for the free motion of the gas, that is the phi, and nb, it is the volume of the free space. Okay, then the available volume or actual volume, it is equal to phi minus nb, where b is the constant and characteristic of a gas. The real gas equation can be written after correcting for this as p in a bracket phi minus nb, it is equal to nRT. Then let us see the pressure correction term. Here, the pressure of real gas is less than the expected pressure due to attraction between the molecules. These attractions slow down the motion of the gas molecules and result in the reduction of frequency of collision over the walls and reduction in the force with which the molecule strikes the wall. Hence, the ideal pressure, that is P ideal, it is equal to P real. That means there should not be attractive forces acting upon the gas molecule. That means the resultant force of attraction is zero. That is the real pressure plus P, where P, it is the reduction in pressure. That means when the resultant force of attraction on that gas molecule is not zero, it is the reduction in pressure. However, the reduction in pressure is proportional to the square of the molar concentration, that means n by phi. Therefore, the reduction in pressure p, it is proportional to n by phi into n by phi. And all of you know n by phi, it is the d square. That means the product of density square. One factor for reduction in frequency of collision and the second factor for the reduction in strength of their impulses on the wall here. Therefore, the reduction in pressure P, it is equal to A in bracket N by phi bracket square, where A, it is the proportionality constant and characteristic of a gas. Therefore, the gas equation we can write as pressure correction term here, P ideal, it is equal to P real plus P, and here we have obtained the value of reduced pressure, and that is the P plus A into N square by phi square. Now, the ideal gas equation can be modified once again by introducing the pressure correction term as P plus A into N square by phi square into phi minus NB, it is equal to NRT, and this is the van der Waals equation of state. For 1 mole of gas, this equation we may write as P plus A upon phi square into phi minus B, it is equal to RT, where this phi, it is the volume occupied by 1 mole of gas. Then remember that this P, it is the absolute pressure of the real gas, where P plus A into N square by phi square, it is the pressure corrected for ideal gas or pressure correction term, and phi, volume occupied by real gas, and is equal to the volume of the container, whereas phi minus NB, it is equal to the available volume of the gas molecules. Then here the units of A and B, here A, it is the pressure correction term, and it has the dimensions atmosphere into liter square into mole raised to minus 2, while this B, it has the dimensions here L into mole raised to minus 1, that means mole liter per mole. Then the characteristics of van der Waals constants A and B. Here A is called the van der Waals constant of attraction. Higher values of A indicate the greater attraction between gas molecules. Once again, I repeat the characteristics of A and B. A and B are called as van der Waals constant, and all of you know A, it is the constant for the pressure correction term, and B, it is the constant for volume correction term. And here this A is also called as the constant of attraction, and remember that higher value of A indicate greater attraction between gas molecules. The easily compressible gases like ammonia, HCl possesses higher values of A. The greater the value of A for a gas, easier is the liquefaction. And B is called the excluded volume, co-volume, vibratory volume, or free space. Okay, and you know B, it is equal to 4 into N into 4 by 3 pi r square, where NA is the Avogadro number, R is the radius of molecule. For a given gas, the number of value, numerical value of A is greater than B. Then the Boyle's temperature TB is the inversion temperature and is related to the van der Waals constant, and it is mathematically given as TB, it is equal to A upon B into R, it is equal to 1/2 into TI. Here note that Boyle's temperature is the temperature at which gases obey ideal gas laws over a wide range of pressure. I repeat, Boyle temperature is the temperature at which the gases obey ideal gas laws over a wide range of pressure. And Inversion temperature is the temperature at which Joule-Thomson coefficient changes its sign, that is from positive sign to negative sign and vice versa. Then see the what is excluded volume. Okay, the van der Waals considered the gas molecules are hard spheres which are not penetrated by other molecule. Consider two hard spheres of radius r in closet. Closest contact r involved by the sphere of radius d, that is forbidden for the centers of the two particles. Suppose we have these two are the hard spheres and they are enclosed in this sphere, then this space which is not available for the motion of the these two gas molecules, that is the excluded volume. Okay, and the derivation of this excluded volume, it is not meant for your syllabus. Okay, so explanation of deviation under different conditions using van der Waals equation. Here all of you know, for 1 mole of gas, the van der Waals equation we can write as P plus A upon phi square into phi minus B, it is equal to RT. And at a low pressure condition, since the volume is large, remember at low pressure condition volume is large and therefore we can neglect the B compared to total volume phi. The van der Waals equation for 1 mole of gas is reduced to here P plus A upon phi square into phi, it is equal to RT, because we have neglected the volume correction term, that means B at a very low pressure. So we got this equation P plus A upon phi square into phi, it is equal to RT. And we simplify this equation here, P phi plus A by phi, it is equal to RT. Therefore, again we simplify this, P phi, it is equal to RT minus A by phi. Here, phi, it is the molar volume and P phi, it is less than RT at lower pressure. Here, P phi, it is less than RT at lower pressure. This is the reason for decrease in Z value at low pressure. By dividing with RT on each side, the above equation can be written as, here P phi by RT, it is equal to 1 minus A by R into T phi, or Z it is equal to 1 minus A upon R T phi. Here at very low pressure, since phi is very large and therefore B and A by phi square values become negligible. Hence the van der Waals equation for 1 mole of gas is reduced to P phi, it is equal to RT. Therefore at very low pressure, all the gases are ideal gases. That means the real gases, they obey ideal gas equation. Then we see a higher pressure condition here. The third case, that is the higher pressure condition. Since the volume of the gas is small at higher pressure, the value of B cannot be neglected. Although A by phi is also large, its value may be neglected. Its comparison with very high pressure value of P. Hence, the van der Waals equation reduced to here P in a bracket phi minus B, it is equal to RT. We simplify this as P phi minus PB, it is equal to RT. Therefore, P phi, it is equal to RT plus PB. Therefore, at high pressure, P phi, it is greater than RT. This explains the rising part of the isotherms at high pressure plotted between Z and P. Then dividing with RT on each side, the above equation can be written as here PV by RT, it is equal to 1 plus PB by RT, or Z it is equal to 1 plus PB by RT. Then at high temperature, next condition, it is at high temperature. In this case, phi is very large and attractions are negligible. Hence, both A and A by phi square are negligible. And this reduces the van der Waals equation to phi, it is equal to RT for 1 mole of gas. Remember, at high temperature condition, the two correction terms, they are negligibly small. Hence, we neglect and the van der Waals equation reduces to PV, it is equal to RT. Then, you know, in case of helium and hydrogen, the actual volume of the gas molecules is very small. The intermolecular forces of attraction are very small. That is, A by phi square can be ignored. Thus, the van der Waals equation reduced to P in a bracket phi minus B, it is equal to RT. Therefore, we can write P phi minus PB, it is equal to RT. Therefore, P phi, it is equal to RT plus PB. Since, therefore, for hydrogen and helium gases, P phi, it is greater than RT. Hence, for these gases, the Z value is always greater than 1, as evident from the isotherms plotted between Z versus P. Then, the next point, isotherms of CO2 gas or Andrews isotherms of the CO2 gas. All of you know, the van der Waals equation holds good for real gases up to moderately high pressure. It explains the isotherms of PV by RT versus P for various gases. And from this equation, it is possible to obtain expressions for Boyle's temperature, then critical constants and inversion temperature in terms of van der Waals constant A and B. So, we have revised the derivation of van der Waals constant and the conditions under which we can neglect and we cannot neglect the correction terms. And remember well, the low pressure condition and high temperature, at this condition real gases obeys the ideal gas equation. The next point, that is the Andrews experiment, we will see tomorrow. Thank you.